You were on MTV in the show Bully Busters. Bully Beatdown. What was the name? The guy that I met here.
The bully.
Who is it? Jason.
Jason Mayhem.
Are you still in touch with him? Are you guys homies?
He's good. We don't have any bad blood. Yeah. I just don't see him.
But you don't talk to him or text him sometimes?
I don't have his number. But that said, you know, he's a good dude. I never had any problems with him.
Good sense of humor, like yourself.
Yeah, like a little weird sense of humor.
But it's okay, I get it.
That's a good dude.
Now, you're one of the few fighters that did the transitions from boxing to MMA. And you were very successful. Nobody mentions you, Jeremy Williams, because they always say boxers never moved over to other sport. How did you do in MMA when you moved over?
How did I do?
How many wins? How many losses?
I had seven fights. I had seven wins, two knockouts, and then five submissions.
But nobody meant, you know what I'm talking about, because they always say, like, MMA guys get into boxing and the boxers beat them. We never see boxers. In boxing, how many championships do you have as a boxer?
I have two world titles and a slew of smaller titles, you know.
What was your final record in boxing?
Don't quote me. 49 fights, 45 wins, four losses. I'm sorry, three losses, one draw, 39, 40 knockouts.
That's incredible.
Something like that.
And why do MMA then, if you're so successful in boxing? What was the reason?
I've been boxing since I was 8 years old. Meaning consistently since I was 8 years old. My dad never let me stop. I wanted to do something else. I got bored with boxing, so I wanted to do something else.
Was it hard doing MMA?
Yes.
A lot of discipline.
Five minute rounds, you know, and the glove is a 4 ounce glove. I hit a guy with a couple of big shots. My hand broke twice. I hit this dude on the right hand and I broke something like that. Don't remember what it was. But I broke my hand like in two places.
What does it feel like when you break a hand? Is it a bit? I mean, because there's the adrenaline of the fight, you may not feel it.
You feel it, but it's not like if you're. You know, if somebody hits your hand with a hammer.
Jeremy, who's the one superstar in your era that you wanted a fight, but a fight never happened? What was the biggest name that you think was avoiding you or just didn't go down? Because you fought everybody.
I don't really have any regrets like that.
There's nobody like that.
My only regret is I should have started as a cruiserweight.
If you went back to 8-year-old Jeremy Williams, what advice would you give about the business of boxing? Business-wise, management, promoters?
They're all crooks. It's just some
who's
are
bigger,
some are smaller.
When I ask, they're all shady. Who's the least shadiest?
Yourself. And the lawyer that you pick.
But how do you stay on top of it? With contracts? So much money coming in, coming out.
Think about this. There's a boxing commission. There's a boxing organization. Like the state, every state has
sanctioning bodies, yep.
But there's no union for us.
You would like the fighters to have a union, like the NBA, like NFL, like baseball.
Boxing makes hundreds of millions of dollars
a year
with nothing for us.
That's why there's no union.
But football makes hundreds of millions.
Yep. NBA, golf, yep.
NBA, baseball, auto racing, there's no union for us. Boxing needs a union ran by fighters, not by
boxing and MMA.
Yes. Combat sport.
Yes, baby. Are you doing
What's his name?
Virgil Williams.
Virgil, congratulations. He told me you were nominated for an Oscar.
A couple years ago.
That's amazing. What do you mean? It doesn't matter. It's for life. It's like winning a championship.
Don't be bashful.
You always
are bashful. Come on, own that shit, Virgil.
Well, how did your life change since getting nominated for an Oscar?
Night and day. Career-wise, it's not good.
All of a sudden, you're popular. Before that, back then, they didn't know me. Now I'm hot. They're on me.
Yeah.
What's the biggest movie you were involved with, a project?
One that's coming out in December.
Can you tell us who's in it?
Michael B. Jordan is starring, Denzel Washington directed.
Oh, that's badass. Denzel a director?
Yeah.
I didn't know he directed.
This is third.
He's a huge boxing fan, by the way.
Yeah.
He used to manage fighters. Yeah. Did you know that?
Denzel Washington?
Yes, he used to manage fighters.
Yeah.
You can see him at the fights all the time. He trains in LA and Los Angeles. You should bring him here once. If he wants to.
I think he's got a spot.
Yeah, he does.
He's got a spot. He's got a
train.
What's that?
Yes.
Beverly Hills, is it?
Yeah.
Is it Beverly Hills?
Beverly Hills adjacent.
Yeah.
It's La Cienega on Olympic.
So almost like right at the edge of Beverly Hills. Yeah.
But you wrote that thing?
Yeah.
Now, how does someone get nominated for an Oscar?
The Academy has to vote. Members of the Academy have to vote it in.
So the writers all vote on that category. So yeah, I was a writer for many years. But everything I voted for never got nominated or voted.
You gotta be a member of the Academy.
No, I was a member. But I'm saying, like, people have a different taste.
You remember the Film Academy?
WGA.
That's the
Writers
union.
Guild.
That's the union.
Yeah, but you get to vote.
Not for the Academy Awards.
Yeah, you used to. No.